guys, so I'm going to go to the thrift stores today and I guess we'll see what we're gonna find today. My phone mount didn't work as well as I thought it would. So yeah, I'm going to the thrift store today with fall clothing on my list of things to get. I'm hoping to get some flannels and sweaters, hoodies, maybe some nice pants, we'll see. And you know how I can never resist the home decor stuff. So, you know, we might find some Halloween and more fall things. I'm not really sure. Yeah. I'm gonna do a thrift with me style video where I show you what I'm finding in the thrift store. So I'll meet you inside. See you guys in a bit. Okay, I just finished going to my first thrift store and now I'm going to go into my second. I got quite a bit from the first store, so we'll see. Okay, going in. Thank you. Hey guys. Okay, so I finished at the second thrift store, which actually has an upstairs and a downstairs, so it's kind of like two thrift stores, but I just see it as one. Anyways, I had to go home and eat lunch because I was starving, so I went and did that, and then I'm heading to my last thrift store of the day, so yeah, let's go in there. Hey everyone, I am back home now. Excuse the bubbling sound, I'm making chicken noodle soup. So we're gonna get into the clothing part of the haul today. I'm not sure if we're gonna get time to do some home decor items that I ended up picking up. I know I was mostly supposed to be just focusing on clothing, but I couldn't resist myself. So let's just get started. So the first item I picked up was this tote. And it's like really puffy and really big, and it is from Old Navy. As you can see, it's like a really dark greeny gray color. I almost thought it was brown when I first seen it, but it's one of those like chameleon colors. It's picking up more brown, I guess, on the camera. But yeah, like even inside it's like really insulated, and like I live in Northern Canada, so it's kind of hard for me to wear fashionable coats during the winter. Yeah, really great coat, really heavy, cool color. It's like a nice neutral for wearing with lots of items. Next thing is this pretty heavy flannel shirt. Now this is what I was really looking for when I was thrift shopping, was this was like the typical flannel in my mind that I was going for. And when I seen it, I thought of pumpkin spice lattes, and that I hit the jackpot of what kind of flannel I was looking for. This is a men's large, and yeah, I really like it. Super heavy and comfy. Next thing I got was this really big oversized shirt. I don't know, I thought it would look really cool with some jeans or leggings. We'll see if it's, I hope it's not too oversized because it is pretty big. The trend right now in fall is really oversized, so we'll see what we can do with this shirt. But see how it kind of has kind of like a towel in a way, like a ridged towel. But I really like the simple look of it. And the next item is this Columbia sweater. It's good to have a few hoodies when it gets cold out, am I right? Shirt I got was this blue blouse. I've seen a lot of blouses like this on Zara's website, and I really wanted one. I really wanted a light blue color too, so when I found this, I thought it was gonna be perfect. And yeah, I've seen like a lot of coats and blouses have these like two shirt pockets on the sides, so yeah, nice shirt. I'm not 100% on this shirt. I really I really do like it. I'll have to see what it looks like on. And there's like beading on the shirt. It's like really looks bohemian and rich and exactly what you would think of fall. And so I'll see what this looks like on. Next item is kind of like a slip dress, I guess. I know it's something you would maybe wear in the spring or the summer. See, the pattern reminds me of like an old couch, but a bit more modern. It's kind of like a silky fabric, but I was thinking you could make this work with maybe some jeans and a sweater maybe. I don't know, I might save it for springtime, but we'll see about wearing it in the fall. I'll style it and see what we can do with it. Next thing I got is kind of something that isn't, I guess, exactly fall-like, but I can't resist funky pants like this. I know it's not typically like a fall type of item, but I just couldn't resist these cool pants. Very hippie-ish. I hope they fit. I did that cool trick of where you put the pants waist around your neck and it's supposed to fit, so we'll see what they look like on. Next thing I got was this really big oversized t-shirt. What I was looking for was like really heavy cotton, and I think this is size extra large. Yeah, 100% cotton Hanes t-shirt. It's not a typical color that I usually go for, or I don't think I have a color like this. And I know it's not very fall like typical fall colors, but I still really like it. So this will be super comfortable and a good basic to have. The next thing I got is this shirt. Kind of has these leaf patterns on it. And I just thought it'd be a good cover up. What if like you wanna not wear a sweater that day, but wearing layers? That's what we're going for, layers. We have another t-shirt. I'd say this is probably from the 90s. But yeah, here is what this says. It says, Hunter's Story, Aboriginal Art, Australia. And then it has like, yeah, kind of Aboriginal art on it. Wear this on a comfy day with like leggings, a tube, I don't know, we'll see. Next is a blouse. I think this is really pretty. Kind of has like a peasant vibe to it. Isn't this pretty? I don't know, I just really thought it was really pretty. Next is this pretty pink shirt. See, I know this is more summer, and I get it, but sometimes you still, like in fall, kind of wear like the crop tops, like layered with flannels and stuff. And so I still thought that I could make this work. And I just love pink, and I just couldn't leave this behind. And it's the same type of kind of peasant style blouse. Thank you. think I got this for my daughter. We'll see if she likes it, but it's this like fuzzy sweater. It's like a half type of shirt with the button up, kind of like a half zip sweater, but instead with buttons. Thought it'd be comfy, and it just reminds me of being cozy in the fall. That's all I got for my clothing. What did you guys think of the outfits? Do you think they're pretty cool or what? Hey, okay. I'm gonna show you the dishes and home goods that I got at the thrift store today. So let's just get started, okay? Okay, so the first thing I got was this funny little umbrella. Look at this. So it actually is like a functional little decorative umbrella. It's like a bird and flower pattern on it, and then like a wooden umbrella thing with the stems. This cost 50 cents. I just thought it was like really cool. You guys, you have to admit that's cool. And then the next thing was this still in a box flower vases. Like, it actually says flower vases. Doesn't that look cool? And I think it was originally from the Buckertoo store, which was an old dollar store here in Canada. But it's unopened, so let's open it up and take a look. Okay, so here is the first vase. It's a really pretty cherry blossom pattern. Next one is just the cylinder style with the cherry blossom pattern. And the next is kind of like a bigger vase style. Isn't it neat that they were still packaged all this time? Forgot to say these vases were only 50 cents for the whole box. Then I found this in the soap dish section, but I might use this for candles or something on my mantle. I'm not really sure yet, but I just really like the light green color. And it feels pretty sturdy. I kind of like the, I don't know, kind of looks contemporary to me, you know what I mean? And this soap dish was $1.50. But like I said, I don't know if I'm using it as a soap dish. I might use it as something else. Then I got these little mini dessert bowls. They look like they're from IKEA, but underneath, like on the bottoms, it doesn't say IKEA. I've always liked these little dishes because I use them for snack dishes, and it's good for like portion control. I just really like the pastel colors. And I paid $1 for each dish, but they're really cute. The next item I got was this Asian gold tin. It's pretty big, but I just loved the little illustrations on the tin. I thought it was like really pretty. And then it has that, let me see if this is the right way. And then it has cranes on the top of the lid. And there's no markings on the bottom, and I only paid 50 cents for this tin. Really happy about this. I've been on the search for placemats, and when I found these, I was like so happy. They are wooden. They're like a wooden tile, and I can't wait to see what this looks like on my table. But I only paid $3 for, oh sorry, there's a set of 6 of these. Yeah, and they look like they're all in good condition, so I really thought that was an awesome find. I actually found another stein. But if you remember in my vlog, I talked about getting one of these, and I just couldn't believe it when I actually found another one. This style is of a man and his dog showing the wife, or woman, their bunny kill. Oh my gosh, I feel bad saying that, but it looks like the bunny has met his end. But yeah, it's in the same style as my other cup, so I'm really excited for that. I'll put a link up here if you want to check out my vlog and see the other cup that I got that kind of is in a similar style. But I only paid 99 cents for this one. Next is this white pitcher. It looks really kind of rustic. It's just kind of country-ish style, I guess. I only paid 99 cents for this, and the bottom says made in Japan. The inside looks pretty good, and yeah, I think this will look really cute as a vase. Next thing I got is this crock looking thing. I think this is what they're called. You see a lot of like teapots and sugar dishes in this style of like glaze, I guess you would call it, but I've never seen a little container like this before. I only paid $2.99 for this, and I don't know, this just really gives me fall vibes. I really like the brown tones in it, and I've been really liking pottery lately, so yeah, really cool. The next thing I got were these four amber juice glasses. Yeah, look how pretty that looks. Super pretty. It just kind of has the dark and then all the way up to like light. I paid $2 each for these. Really pretty. And I got this teapot with a carp. Is this like a carp fish? Or would it be a koi? Floral design on the lid. Really neat handle, actually. Yeah, this was a two-piece set. I forgot. It came with a little teacup. Remember, I've said before in my haul videos that I really like the teacups. But it has like the same fish design. It has some lettering on there that I'm not sure what it says. So this little two-piece set was $3.99. And while we're on the subject of teapots, I'll show you the next teapot I got. This is like a pretty heavy teapot. It's glass. It says Sadler, made in Staffordshire, England. It has this like really neat kish looking pattern on it. It's good on the inside. I like how it's like a little fat looking spout. But yeah, I paid $4 for this little teapot. Okay, next I got these pig napkin holders. I don't know why I got these, but I did. I have never owned napkin holders in my life. I've always wanted to, but I've never seen ones that I enjoyed. But these little lazy pig napkin holders look cute. And also in my garage sale haul, I'll put a link up for that too. I got this cherub looking thing and I figured it out that it's a napkin holder, but I only found one. So far I have these four pigs and a cherub napkin holder. So now I just gotta find napkins. I used to have napkins, but I do not have them anymore. So I don't know where they went, but I haven't been able to find any good napkins. So I hope I'll find some soon. So here are these little pig napkin holders. Super cute. So these are three votive candle holders. I actually had five of these in my cart, but I accidentally hit like a whole like bump in the thrift store and it sent my cart flying and it broke two of these, tragically. I think these will look really cute on a tablescape. They're just really unique and heavy and tall. I think the light will bounce off beautifully off of these, but I only paid 50 cents each for these, so I'm thinking I'm gonna use them in my Thanksgiving tablescapes, so check that out. And I got these thinking of Easter time. Look how pretty that pattern is, and I just love white dishes. And I only paid $1 each for these. Like, even the flowers are kind of 3D on them. Like, isn't that pretty? So yeah, I'm gonna use these for Easter time. Like, I know we're shopping for fall and Halloween and stuff, but that's kind of how things happen sometimes, as you end up seeing different season things that you're going to want to use in the future. So next Easter you'll be seeing these somewhere in my house, and they are so gorgeous. Did I say that these were for eggs, if you didn't know? Yeah, you put like a boiled egg in them and then you can like crack them and eat them. So yeah, really cute egg holders. Next is this really cool looking basket type of trinket box. This was actually in the soap holders too, where I found that green one I showed you earlier. So I'm not sure if somebody used it for soap or if somebody just misplaced it and put it in there. To me, it looks more like little trinket box. It's really pretty and really delicate looking. There is a couple chips on the flower, but I still couldn't leave it behind. I just thought this looked really pretty. It kind of has like a shabby chic, granny chic vibe to it. And this was $1.50. I got more luck in the juice glass department in this really neat red stripe pattern. But yeah, these cups are really nice. So I paid 50 cents each for these cups. I've been really liking this dotted type of pottery, and I really like the caramel and the brown, but this is just like a nice little serving bowl. One cannot have enough serving bowls. I don't know, I do have lots of bowls, but I just thought this was a really pretty one. I didn't have one in brown, so I paid $1.50 for this one, and it's Baycrest stoneware made in Japan. And then I got this linen table runner. I've been looking for a table runner for my table. And this one just had a really pretty rose and daisy pattern on it. Yeah, I really like that. Really pretty. And I paid $2 for it. I think this is called transferware. Is that what this is called? But yeah, the blue and white kind of transferware, I think it's called. Please correct me if I'm wrong. Kind of country scene with somebody sitting on the bridge thinking about their life in this beautiful landscape type of plate. I wouldn't want to live there. I just want to jump right in. But yeah, I paid $2.50 for it, and it is made in Japan. Next thing is this Buddha with a fan. I think it's a Buddha. He has like a little hole in his belly, and it's kind of empty in the back. So I'm thinking that you put an incense in here and light it up, I think, and that it just smokes out. I think that's what it is, but I thought it was really cool. I think I paid $2 for this one. Next are these two vases that are this cream color. They kind of look like they're Greek or Italian or something to me. There's no markings on the bottom, and I paid $4 for this. And I know you heard me say shelves way too many times in my last video, but this will look nice on my shelf. And the next item is a super heavy, like, oh my gosh, you guys, this is very heavy. This feels like it's like 5 pounds, but it is this marble, and it has like a little bit of red residue from the last candle that was in here. But this is a candle holder, and I think this will look really cool. Marble look and how heavy it is. I just don't have a candle holder like this. So really happy to add something like this to my collection. This is the first set that I got, was like a blue transferware. Here are the two plates. There's only two plates, and how many cups?
4, 5, 7
cups and only two plates. So maybe I'll like complete my collection at some point in my life. But here's the first pattern. It's called Old Willow Mayotte, made in Staffordshire, England, hand engraved pattern permanent. It's kind of in a temples. It look like Japanese or Chinese temples. It looks like kind of a really Asian design, and the cup kind of has the same type of look. And I lucked out with getting actually two sets of transferware, but this time in the brown color. This one I got 6 plates and 6 cups. And this one is in the Johnson Brothers Stoke-on-Trent, England, Cotswold, made in England. But yeah, the pattern is like kind of like a village or a house type of pattern. I just really like the brown. I like the brown and the blue, but I was really happy about finding this. And the teacup just kind of echoes the same thing that you see on the side plate. So that wraps up my thrift haul, thrift with me video today. I hope you guys really enjoyed my haul. It was quite a big one, so thank you for watching it all the way through if you did. What'd you think of the items I tried on? Any home goods that you really enjoy, or any ideas of how you would style them? Thank you so much for watching. Hello to my 349 subscribers. I just checked. Thanks a lot, guys, for all your support. Please like and comment, because that really helps my channel. And I really like to hear what you guys have to say about everything. So bye, guys. Don't forget to subscribe, like, comment, share to your thrift store loving friends. I would really love that. It'd be much appreciated. I'll see you guys next week with a new video. Bye, guys, and I'll see you next week. See ya.